Hey, what's up, everyone? My name is Dell from True Essence Connection. And I wanted to share with you guys an insight I had for myself on my own personal journey that I know is going to resonate with so many people. And what it's about is I was trying to be a good spiritual person, making sure that I do things the right way and not to do things the wrong way. And I brought awareness to that. And I realized that this thing was a similar thing that I was doing before, in which, for those of you who don't know, I was raised in a Christian family, in which I wanted to make sure that I was trying to be a good boy for the fear of potentially going to hell or opening the door for the devil, those type of things. So I would do things unnaturally for the most part for trying to be a good person. And I'm sure every single person can raise their hand of like, we have like just thoughts that come up, whether it's lustful thoughts, it's just thoughts about this person, judgment, even judgment towards ourselves, but even just having some cravings for things. And for me, like, I would have these thoughts and I would suppress them as quickly as possible for the fear of, no, I don't want to open the door and let the devil in and this stuff, and the fear of going to hell and going the eternal damnation type of thing. So it's an interesting catch 22, because I was able to identify this same pattern that was happening in the spiritual world, in which I was doing my very best to keep myself at a high vibration frequency and not to do things that's going to lower my vibration. And my beliefs was the things that will lower my vibration is, oh, if you eat this food, it's going to lower your vibration. If you have these thoughts, it's going to lower your vibration. If you feel anger or whatever these emotions are, it's going to lower your vibration. And I had this fear of lowering my vibration, which inevitably lowered my vibration. It's very interesting how there's like a similarity between the spiritual teachings and the religious teachings and the essence of it and that limited portion of it. I mean, there's truth in both sides of things, but then they both have like those limiting things that could potentially happen for trying to not be who you are in the moment for the fear of lowering your vibration or for the fear of the boogeyman getting you. And both sides in spirituality, the boogeyman is you lower your vibration, or there's a lot of stuff that could be the boogeyman, but stopping yourself from really experiencing life how you want to experience life for the fear of it lowering your vibration. That's where I was at. And it's a fucking struggle. It's a struggle to force myself to be something other than myself for the fear of what can happen if I just be myself. You hear that? What can happen when I actually just be myself? And recently, what I've been doing, and it's for a couple months now, is I've been embracing all my shit. I like to watch ratchetness. I like to watch TV. I can watch the news. I can see what's going on. I like to be updated with the current events. I actually have a fear before of watching the news because it's going to lower my vibration by seeing what's going on in the world, compared to like, yo, I like to see what's going on with the world for just staying connected with like what's really happening in here. And there's a fine borderline to me between detaching from something and not doing something for the fear of some work that's going to have to get done, spirituality. And I think they call it spiritual bypassing. So I asked myself the question of, what would it be like in which I can do whatever I want, I can experience whatever I want, and I can still just be in a space in which I can see everything, I can accept everything, I can see the truth in everything, and I can also be able to experience it fully. And that's what I've been doing lately for the past couple months, and it's been pretty fun. Like, I'm having fun. I watch different shows. I like to get stay updated with the current events in the news, what's going on, and I also get to hear the opinions from everybody from all different perspectives for what exactly is happening, what they think about it. It's pretty cool because you get to really just see the creative things that are happening for everybody's perspectives. And of course, I have the right. I can filter in and filter out the stuff that doesn't resonate with me. But I gave myself the freedom now of my own spiritual practice. Not a spiritual practice I feel like I need to do or have to do it this certain way, but it's a practice in which every moment could be a spiritual practice, and I can actually choose in the moment how I would like to practice it. So much more freedom. It's like a weight taken off my shoulders. And also, I'm having fun. I get to learn a lot of stuff and hear different teachings and hear different experiences, but also, I get to experience life. I get to experience spirituality in life. How are you experiencing your life right now? Are you experiencing your life for the fear of the boogeyman coming to get you if you do things a certain way? Or are you allowing yourself to experience life how you want to experience life? Either way is okay. I just like to share my perspective so that way you could potentially see another way if you're open to it. If not, cool. But for me, I'm about to get back to my ratchetness. Stay connected.